Welcome to Personal Finance 101. My name is Franz. In today's show, we're going to talk about the 9 habits that changed my life that may also change your life. We're going to talk about them. We're going to go one by one and explain how good they are. Where do I get them? They are millionaire habits. They are successful people habits. And I grab them. I use them and they work very well for me. They change my life. Today, we're going to talk about the 9 habits that allow me to be a better person, for me to better organize my life, my personal life, my health life, my marriage life, my family life. All of these habits help me to be a better person. If this is your first time listening to our show, please subscribe down below. It's completely free and it will help the channel grow. Also, always give us a thumbs up if you like what you hear. If you learn something from this program, share it with other friends. Let them know about our channel, Personal Finance 101. My name is Franz. We're going to talk today about 9 habits that help me grow, help me be a better person today. First one is wake up early. I know a lot of you are going to say, oh, you know, I'm not a morning person. You know, I cannot wake up early. Well, I got to tell you, a habit is something that you do over and over and it becomes a routine. If you don't try it, you're not going to know if you like it or not. I wake up early every day. And I got to tell you, a lot of successful people, a lot of millionaires wake up early. What the beauty about waking up early? First of all, when you wake up early, everybody else is still sleeping. There are less people on the street. There's less noise in your house or around you, wherever you are, there is less people. I take the example of the street because if you like to walk, you can go out in the morning and walk. This is the best time where you're by yourself and you think, you look at all your finances, your life, you think better, and you take time to do things that you like for you without anybody else bothering you or other obligations to come to you and stop you from doing something that you want or something that you like to do for you. Waking up early allows you to organize your mind. It allows you to be free, allows you to relax, no pressure. There's nothing else going on. It's 5 a.m. and you're all by yourself. You can meditate, you can pray, you can think, you can decide what you want to do with your day, your week, your month, your year, your life. It's a time where you can be quiet, you can be alone, you can be with yourself and decide, make decisions, think better. Waking up early for me was a major change in my life. The second habit that was well for me and worked perfectly, it's reading self-improvement books or listening to self-improvement videos, listening to successful people's story. I have a lot of books that I read. Let me tell you, I read a lot. I listen a lot. I watch a lot of videos. This allows you to look for a role model, that allow you to look for mentors, that allow you to see what other people are doing, allow you to see that everybody's not the same. We look the same, but we are not the same. And you can see other people's behavior. What do they do? How do they organize their life? Why are they successful and you're not? And you can copy and paste and adjust what they did and put it to fit better for you. Self-improvement books, it's very powerful. It gives you new ideas, new thoughts, things you thought they were impossible. And when you read about somebody else that did it, what they went through, how many issues that they had, how many hurdles that they had to fight or go over in order for them to accomplish their dream and become what they are today. And you learn that little thing that you had, you thought that was complicated, you just realized, oh boy, if this guy did this and he went through it, I can do the same and I can beat those challenges that I have in my life every day. The third habit is to set goals, written goals. I got to tell you, writing is something that I love to do because you got to write it in order for you to visualize it, in order for you to better see it, better understand it, in order for you to tell the world that they exist, in order for you to challenge yourself. Setting written goals, daily goals, weekly goals, monthly goals, yearly goals, 3 years goals, 5 years goals, 10 to 20 years goals. Daily goals is what we used to call a to-do list. It is something that you write for you to do one by one today with prioritize. Remember, you got to prioritize. So you put what you think is more important to do first. What you think is more challenging, put it first. So that way you get it out of the way. It doesn't bother your brain. Anything that you think you need to do today, put it down from 1 to 10 to 20 to 50 with what's more important today. And then the next day, when you wake up in the morning, you look at the list that you had yesterday. And if you had things that you didn't finish, you didn't complete, you didn't find the proper person, put it down again on that list in order for you to follow up and get it done today. Writing goals, very important. Number four, my fourth habit is I have multiple streams of income. I call them buckets. I have different buckets that allow me to have a peace of mind. If you only have a 9-to-5 job, you always worry about if that company go down, if my boss fire me, if they're unhappy with my results, if this, if that. When you have multiple streams of income, you feel better. You feel that you don't need to work a 9-to-5. You can choose to do it in order for you to guarantee a certain security, a paycheck every 2 weeks, health insurance, benefits, 401k, all that. But you know that you have other places where you make money on things that you like, on things that you love to do. Anything you can do that create an extra income is a multiple stream of income. You can buy a property and get money out of it. 200 a month, 300 a month, extra money. You can buy stocks, buy and hold stocks, extra money. You can do daily trade if you want to, extra money. You can create a YouTube channel, extra money. You can do everything that you like. The bottom line is you have to generate different type of money in different sources. They call them multiple streams of income. Number five, you have to do a monthly budget, a written monthly budget. Remember, I just mentioned to you the power of writing. Monthly budget allow you to know where your money is going, to be in control of your money. You know how much money is coming in, how much money is going out. That allow you to save money, that allow you to spend less. You spend less than you make in order for you to save. And that money you save, you invest it. I always talk about it, compounding interest investment for you to make more money. Written monthly budget allows you to be in control of your money. Number six, take time for you. Take time for yourself. I do it in the morning. You can choose to do it anytime during the day, but you have to allocate time for you. You give time to everybody in your life, your work, your boss, your children, your wife, your friends, society. Get a chance and give yourself time. If you like to meditate, if you want to pray, if you want to be with yourself, anytime, give yourself 5 minutes. Try it. Give yourself 5 minutes every day for you when you can be with yourself and think clearly, peacefully, and trying to see, okay, what I like to do? What would I like to do for my birthday, for Christmas, for Thanksgiving? Where I see myself? How do I like to live? What do I like to do? It's good. That will make you feel good. Try it. Give yourself 5 minutes every day. If you want to do it when you wake up, if you want to do it before you go to bed, anytime that you choose to do it, 5 minutes every day for you. Number seven, stop procrastinating. Act. Do it. You want to do something? Well, there are some steps that you got to do. Make research, find out, learn about it, and act on it. Don't stay, don't procrastinate. Oh, you know, if I could, if this I could. Stop doing the if, just act on it. In order for you to act, there's a minimum research that's needed. But stop researching. Oh, it's not time yet. Stop doing that. It's time for you to do it. When you want to do it, now is the time. You have enough research. If you don't go in the pool, you won't be able to swim. If you don't pick up, sit in front of that car, in front of that wheel, you're not going to be able to know how to drive that car. You have to act on it. You have to do it. Stop procrastinating. Number 8, understand where you invest your money. Remember, we just spoke about saving money. The next thing is investing the money. Before you go do something, you gotta research it. We just talked about don't procrastinate. Yes, you have to act on it. Don't just go and do something. You have to research it. You gotta know about it. You gotta look at the people that are successful in it. What did they do? What mistakes did they make? And you have to go for it. So understand, if you want to go do daily trade, understand it. If you want to do option trading, go read about it, find out the people that do it, how they do it, and you can adjust your own way. If you want to buy and hold real estate, stocks, anything you want to do, you want to invest in index fund, read about it, find out how much interest that it gives, which one is better and why, and then do it. You want to invest in real estate, you can do the same thing. Whatever you choose to invest, you want to buy product online and resell them. You want to create an Amazon store. You want to do a YouTube channel. Whatever you want to do, research it first so you have an idea of where you're going, what you need, and what mistakes other people made before you. And that way you learn that you don't go and make the same mistakes. Number 9, don't follow the crowd. I remember one successful person said, if you don't know where you're going, or if you don't know where to go, look at where the crowd is going and go the opposite way. I gotta tell you, there are 11 million millionaires in America, which is about 3.something%. It's not even 4% of the population. 96% of the people are going in a different direction. 4% are going in the other side. So where do you think you need to go? The other side. Don't follow the crowd just because people are doing something and you want to do it yourself. I remember when I was a kid, I used to be sick every 3 months. Every time the season changed, I was getting sick. I was getting a cold. I was getting a fever. And that was really weird for me. All the other kids don't get sick as often as me. And they always laugh at me and saying, oh, look at you. You're getting sick all the time. And I keep going to doctors and they keep giving me medication, but nothing ever changed. Till one day, I find a doctor that sit down with me and tell me, explain to me a few things about how you do stuff. He asked me, when you wake up in the morning, do you walk barefooted? Because the majority of the houses where I grow up are tile. He says, cold. The tile is cold in the morning. Do you wake up and you just walk barefooted to go to the bathroom? I say, yeah, I do that. When you do exercise, because I do a lot of exercise, and you sweat, do you keep your t-shirt wet on you? Yes, I do. He said, you see all those things? They are bad for you because your body is not like everybody else's body. It's not because you see somebody else do something and you think you can just go and do it. Everybody's situation is different. After he told me that, I changed the way I do things. I exercise right after I'm done. I remove the wet t-shirt and I put a dry one. Let me tell you, that makes a huge difference in my life. The other thing he told me is you need to sleep. I need 9 hours of sleep. You know, a lot of people may be laughing right now and say, oh, you know, I only sleep 5 hours and I'm fine. Well, that's you. My body requires 8 to 9 hours of sleep. I sleep early and I wake up early. I don't watch basketball games till 1 a.m. I don't stay watching TV late. A lot of other successful people don't do it either. What they do is they go online and they watch the resume. A game lasts 4 hours. You can watch it on YouTube for 20 minutes. They concise everything for you and you see all the aspects of the game. You lack sports, you can do that. Wake up at 5 a.m. and watch a 20 minutes game that lasts 4 hours of your time last night. If that's what you want to choose to do, if this is what you want to do, that's fine. But try other habits and see if they may help you be a better person. You need to be in control of your time, of yourself, of your financial life, of your personal life, of your health life. How to be in control. Be in control of your time by writing stuff in your agenda, by putting stuff in your calendar. Be in control of your health by knowing what are you eating. Exercise if you like it. Go visit your doctor every year. Be in control of your family life by doing what? By listening to your kids, to your spouse, by giving them time, by enjoying life. Be in control of your finance by doing what? By checking your bank statement every day, by looking at your credit card statement, by controlling where you spent your money, by doing a monthly budget, by spending less than what you earn, by saving money, by investing the money that you save in a compound interest channel where you can make more money. My name is Franz. You're listening to Personal Finance 101. Today, we explain to you the 9 habits that changed my life, the 9 habits that can change your life. Our sponsor for today's show is Progressive Tutoring. If you have your children that needs help with school work, they are slow, they're getting not good grades, you want A, B grade, call Progressive Tutoring. They will help you. They have certified teachers that can tutor your children and learn better ways for them to get better grades. We put information down below. We always have different links where you can click and learn a lot more than the time that we spent with you today. Thank you so much. See you then.